Imaginative genius, 100 years ahead of his time. He wrote of a marvelous submarine, a record-breaking trip around the world, a journey to the center of the earth, a flight to the moon. Many of his imaginings have come true, and who can say that all of them will not? In his great book, Career of a Comet, Jules Verne tells of a mysterious adventure in time and space. And the story begins in North Africa, in Oran, Algeria, May 16th, 1881. In the crowded streets, the bazaars, swarms of humanity. Outside the city, a silent group of men.
Gentlemen.
Michael Denning, soldier of fortune from County Clare, Ireland. Captain Hector Servadac of the French Army. Their purpose, kill one another.
There is no chance for reconciliation?
So far as Captain Servadac is concerned, none.
Only an apology will satisfy Mr. Denning.
Impossible.
1 million women, young and beautiful, here and in France, and they have to quarrel about one woman. One woman.
Thank you, Alan.
Thank you, Gaston.
Gentlemen, if you please. At the count of 10, you may turn and fire. Are you ready? One, two. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Thank you.
God, Servadac, what happened?
I don't know. The city swept away. What was it? An earthquake? Hurricane? That wind was like no hurricane this earth has ever known. All our friends are lost. Leclerc was like a brother to me. Mr. Denning, nothing has changed between us. But under the circumstances, I feel we must postpone the duel.
Yes, of course, I quite agree.
Let us proceed in the direction of the city. Perhaps we can discover what this terrible thing was. At least there are living things here. Birds, trees.
Insects.
I can't account for such a sudden change of terrain. I've never heard of a place like this in Algeria.
Well, at least we won't die of thirst. This country looks like it could provide some food, too.
We may not find a better place to spend the night. I propose to stay here.
Oh, you too, huh? Well, in that case, Captain Servadac, I bid you good night, sir.
Mr. Denning.
What?
Whether we like it or not, we must remain together in order to survive. Who knows what lies ahead of us?
Yes, well, I suppose you're right. But understand, the quarrel between us still exists and must be settled.
I understand perfectly.
What was that?
I've never seen a creature like that.
What's the matter?
I can't find the North Star.
Yes, you're right. Where is it?
And for that matter, where is the moon? If you recall, last night we had a full moon. It should... The Southern Cross?
Well, that's impossible. How could we be in the Southern Hemisphere?
The stars in the heavens, man. Look at them. There's only one conclusion. This catastrophe, whatever it was, has thrown the Earth into a new orbit.
That whole thing is unbelievable.
It is unbelievable. But how else could you explain this?
I have no explanation.
Gigantic earth shocks, terrible winds, our friends swept away. Servadac. Could it be that we're the last survivors left on Earth?
I don't know. I pray that we are not. We have one bullet in each pistol. We must take turns on guard and keep the fire burning.
All right. I'll take the first turn.
All right.
Were those, do you suppose? Certainly not human.
Subhuman, perhaps.
I've seen faces like those be... Yes, of course, in a museum, Neanderthals. Captain Servadac, you saved my life.
We agreed that we needed one another to survive.
Yes, that's true. This is a bit awkward. I owe you my life. I obviously can't fight a duel with you now.
They might come back with the others. I suggest that we move on.
All right.
These are useless now.
These are better.
No, when I was a lad, I used to consider berries a great delicacy.
There's game here. We'll try to bag some.
I hope so. No,
Funny, but I'm not a bit hungry now. Seem to have lost all my appetite.
Past, 100,000 years past. That beast there, the men we fought last night, straight out of the Stone Age.
Stone Age? That's incredible. How?
The question was how. Well, I don't know how, but I can tell you this. That beast lying there is a plateosaur of a species that flourished on Earth more than 1,000 centuries ago. Thank you, Mr. Denning.
I was merely repaying an honorable debt. The scales are balanced now.
Yes, they are.
Captain Servadac.
Hector, don't... please.
Hector, the lady was charming, beautiful, and it may seem a little indelicate of me to say it, but don't you think that she...
That she had Dasson to fight?
Uh-huh.
I'm sure of that.
The moon is rising. It's not lost to us after all.
It's enormous. Perhaps our new orbit takes us closer to it. God help us. It's the Earth.
Yes, you're right. I can see the British Isles. Spain, the coast of Africa?
There's only one explanation that fits all the facts as we know them. It's beyond all belief, yet it must be. A heavenly body. A small planet. Or a comet, perhaps. Collided with the Earth and bore us into space. Carrying an envelope of the Earth's atmosphere with us.
It's incredible.
Of course it is, but believe me, this is the only explanation that makes sense. Many comets are periodic, as you know. They return to proximity with the Earth again and again.
Yes, I know.
Now, suppose our comet returned every 100,000 years. And suppose it struck the Earth a glancing blow 1,000 centuries ago, just as it did us. Carrying a fragment of the Earth, complete with the men, the animals, and the vegetation of that time.
I see. And separated from the Earth, spare the destructive forces of the Ice Age, evolution might conceivably have stood still, huh?
I'm convinced it did. And it is in this land, a fragment of the distant past, that we now find ourselves.
This whole thing fairly boggles the mind. Yet, as you said yourself, what other explanation is there? Our Mother Earth. My friends, my family are there. And to them, I'm dead.
But we are not dead. We are alive and hungry. There you are. Roast partridge. Hmm? Prehistoric partridge. Oh. A dish fit for a king. Even the chef of the Fontainebleau could not burn it with such finesse.
Thank you, Hector. Miserable night that was.
We'll have some food. That should warm you up. If we find something with a fine, warm pelt, so much the better.
That's another proof of your theory, Captain. The Earth's crust was less stable 1,000 centuries ago.
Thank you.
prehistoric ancestors of our modern-day elephants. Take a look at those ox-like animals among them. Now, if we could find one of them away from the herd, we might be able to kill it.
Meat for a long time?
Yeah, not only that, but as you said yourself, a fine warm pelt for clothing. We wouldn't have to freeze the way we did last night.
That's right.
You know, I've been thinking about that idea of yours, Captain. This land here is a fragment of our prehistoric world. And I'm inclined to think that maybe you might be right.
Oh, you accepted my theory.
Except for one thing. Now, a comet travels at hundreds of miles per second, right?
True.
Then how could it smash into the Earth, pick up a vast area of land as neatly as a man scooping out a piece of melon, and yet not shatter everything into dust?
I don't know exactly, but the Earth moves in orbit around the sun. It also spins in its polar axis. Perhaps both motions coincided with the course of the comet.
And the Earth rolled with a blow like a boxer taking a hard punch, huh?
Yes, something like that.
Yeah, I see.
I don't believe they're going to separate. We better move on. Exactly, a warm welcome.
Yes, but at least they're human and not like those Neanderthals that attacked us. Apparently the process of evolution didn't stand still.
Yes, they post guards, they obey a leader.
And they cook food.
What the... Handsome, huh?
Dashing. They're coming back with the men of the tribe. Find a link with a civilized world.
Yeah, we are both in the height of fashion. Hmm?
Indeed we are.
They don't seem to have been after us.
I don't think they're even from the same tribe as the others. Did you notice every man wears a shell necklace?
They look like a hunting party to me.
Or more likely a war party. In prehistoric times, the tribes were very small, scarcely larger than family units. They were constantly at war with one another.
Maybe they're on their way to pick a scrap with the fellas we stole these skins from, huh?
Quite possibly.
Well, whatever they are, we need them. They're humans. Now, we've got to find some way to approach those fellas.
How? The weak will run away and the strong will try to kill us. It's difficult to explain a peaceful mission with half a dozen spears stuck through you, my friend.
Thank you.
Thank you. Rita?
Rita.
Food. Rita, food.
Food?
Yes, food.
Food.
Stone.
Shashi.
Shashi. Stone.
Stone.
Good. Stone.
Stone. Dabo?
Dabo?
Dabo.
Dabo. Bird. Bird. Dabo.
Bird. Dabo.
Dabo.
Bird.
Bird.
Bird. Rishi.
Water. Rishi, water.
Water.
Rishi. Drink. Water. Drink. Water.
Drink. Water.
Very good, Sherry. Very good. Sherry. Sherry.
Sherry?
Sherry.
Dina.
Dina. Sherry.
Sherry.
Yes, my sweet one, Sherry.
Sherry. Sherry!
Can't a man have a little privacy? Go away, go, go, go. You, go. Go! Ah.
Face to wake up to.
Thank you, dear heart. Thank you.
I don't need that, Natita.
Anoka, kill.
No, he won't. No, no, no. Anoka is big and strong, but he's stupid. I, on the other hand, I'm very smart.
Anoka, kill.
No, no, I'm telling you he won't. No. Do you know where this is? This is a sling, just like the one David used to kill Goliath. But you wouldn't know about David and Goliath, would you, huh? Well, now you just watch me and I'll show you. My gun might be a little bit more spectacular, I admit, but I think this'll do the trick all right. Kill you. Now get up and get out of here. Go on, go! Go! There, there, dear heart. Just remembered my Sunday school lessons, that's all.
Food?
Thank you.
You eat. Water? You drink.
That's very good, Cherie.
Sherry?
You think Sherry means love me, hmm? Come, Lena. Let's go down to the river.
Sulfur. And charcoal as close as the nearest campfire. Only one thing missing. I know you don't understand, Dina. Not only strange words, but strange ideas as well. 19th century ideas, such as gunpowder. Sulfur, charcoal, potassium nitrate. Boom.
Boom.
Caverns.
Caverns?
If I remember my lessons correctly. Come, Dina. Thank you.
Victor. Sherry?
Friend?
Friend? Hector? Friend?
Hector? He's alive!
Friend. Sherry?
It's amazing how a Frenchman always finds a woman.
Thank you.
You stay there, huh? Now, look. It's good. Water. You take. Take. That's it. There, you see? That's good, huh?
Tito, what's the matter? What are you crying for?
Oh, yeah. I see. You thought because I took this woman, I... Oh, you poor little pigeon. Look. How am I going to explain to you now? Look, look, listen. Look at me now. Look. You belong to me. Only you. Right? Yeah, come here, you. Come on. Come over here. No, no, no. Now, look. This girl, no. No. See? This girl belong Hector, my friend. But this girl, Tita, she belong to me. Hmm? Yes.
Dina. Elma, Hyena, Mubudu, Dina.
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 Cave.
Dina.
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 Ada. Ada. Tana. Dina.
Kuig Fer. Hamdal.
Oh. I take woman to Hector, my friend.
Hector!
Escape.
Oh, you forget the look of the Irish. But you know, when I found that place where you went over the cliff, I thought you were finished.
Well, I was hurt, but I survived, thanks to Dina.
I don't survive, don't I? But the point I thought,
he says that the people we left behind are trapped in a cave, besieged by giant beasts. Now, it's plain enough to see what happened. The volcano burned down the forest, driving the creatures out. And some of them attacked our people, killing several of them. And the rest took refuge in the cave.
Are they safe there?
Well, only as long as they can keep their fires going. And they're also running short of food and water. Now, they're depending on me to do something to help them.
I'll bring some help, Michael. Good luck.
All right. Riley.
Here. Sulfur.
To you.
You to me. Yellow. Huh? Huh?
For heaven's sake, explain to them.
It's a tap.
Charcoal. Black.
You.
To me.
Uh,
Sulfur, 10%. Charcoal, 15%.
Potassium nitrate, 75%.
I've got hides like armor plate. What can we do?
A faith, man. Faith can move mountains, and so can gunpowder.
Gunpowder? Then we will move the mountain right on top of their ugly heads. You see that cliff right above them?
Yes, you should have been a military engineer.
The overhang of the cliff protects some of them, but we'll lure them out into the open so that you can get a better shot at them, right?
Good luck.
Charge up.
Strange quarrelsome people. Less than an hour ago, they joined forces against the common enemy. Now they're ready to fight again.
Strange people indeed, but are they so unlike modern man? You recall that we met for the express purpose of shooting each other.
You are right. But shall we now attempt to set an example of inter-tribal goodwill?
By all means.
Go ahead.
I've been studying the heavens night after night. I believe our comet is in a new orbit and will probably take us close to the Earth in about 7 years.
Well, that's great news. But do you suppose we'll get back there again?
I don't know. But we have 7 years to plan, to prepare.
7 years? Well, that's not too long.
No, not long at all.